First off, let's throw up the word congruency, just to remind you. It's two shapes that are congruent are exactly the same in every respect, same length of sides and same angles. Congruent shapes are exactly the same. Whereas similar shapes, their angles must be the same and their sides in ratio. If you look at these two shapes here, this angle will equal that one, this angle will equal that one, this angle will equal that one, and this angle will equal that one. And the sides are in ratio. For example, this could be twice as long as this, this could be twice as long as this, this is twice as long as this, and this is twice as long as that. So to be similar, the angles must be the same, and the sides must be in ratio. Now if you have two triangles, you can't have one without the other anyway. If your angles are the same, then the sides must be in ratio. Or if the sides are in ratio, then the angles must be the same. Similar shapes, angles are the same, and sides are in ratio. Now we talked about a do enlargement. So if we're asked to enlarge a shape, we need a shape, we need an enlargement scale factor, and we need a centre of enlargement. So let's make that the centre of enlargement. When you've got the centre of enlargement, you draw lines. I call them radiating lines because they sort of radiate out. There's no real word for these at all. You draw lines through each of the vertices of the shape that you wish to enlarge, and then you measure the distance from your centre of enlargement to a vertice, and then you multiply it by your scale factor. So if that's 2 centimetres, I then measure from there 6 centimetres. If that distance there is 5 centimetres, then 3 fives, I measure 15 centimetres, which is there. Now the thing is, when you enlarge your shape, this line must be 3 times longer than that line and parallel. This line, if done accurately, should be 3 times longer than that and parallel. And the line down here, 3 times longer than that. And the line across here, 3 times longer than that. So for an enlargement, you need a scale factor and a centre of enlargement. If you have a negative scale factor, if you have a negative scale factor of 2, let's have a centre of enlargement here. So you draw your radiating lines. When you measure this distance, you multiply it by the scale factor, in this case scale factor 2, but measure it in the opposite direction. So if that was 1.5 centimetres, then I'd measure back 3 centimetres. If this distance was 2 centimetres, I'd measure back 6 centimetres. If this distance was 5 centimetres, I'd measure back 15 centimetres. What you in fact get is a shape where all the sides are twice as long, but the negative has the fact of turning upside down, or inverts, it is the proper term. So if you enlarge by a whole number, it doesn't matter if it's positive or negative, all the lengths of sides will be that many times bigger. The negative just turns it upside down. If, however, you enlarge by a fractional scale factor, so if the centre of enlargement was there, I measure that distance and halve it. I measure that distance and halve it. So in fact, what you do is get a shape where all the sides are half as long. So just to revise what I've been saying, if you enlarge a shape by scale factor 4, it doesn't matter if it's positive 4 or negative 4, all the sides will be 4 times as long. But the negative will make the shape go upside down or inverted. If you enlarge by a quarter, it doesn't matter if it's positive quarter or negative quarter, all the sides will be a quarter the length that they were. All the sides will be a quarter the length that they were. The negative just has the effect of turning upside down. Now the other thing with the enlargement is to appreciate the effect on area. So if we have a shape, a nice simple shape like a rectangle, if we enlarge this by scale factor 2, all the sides will be twice as long. But if you look at this, then in fact the area has become 4 times. So if you enlarge a shape by scale factor 2, then the area will in fact be 4 times as large. So the ratio of the sides is 1 to 2, but the ratio of the areas is 1 to 4. All the sides will be twice as long, but the area, no matter what shape it is, will be 4 times larger. If you enlarge by scale factor 3, then all the sides will be 3 times as long. But in fact, the area will be 9 times bigger. So, if you enlarge by scale factor 3, the ratio of the sides is 1 to 3, but the ratio of the areas is 1 to 9. If you enlarge something by scale factor 3, all the sides are 3 times longer, no matter what the shape is, but the area will be 9 times bigger. Putting that into a table, if you enlarge by scale factor 2, then all the lengths are twice as big, but the area will be 4 times. If you enlarge by scale factor 3, all the lengths will be 3 times bigger, but the area will be 9 times. If you enlarge by scale factor 4, all the lengths will be 4 times bigger, but the area will be 16 times bigger. If you enlarge by scale factor 5, then the area will be 25 times bigger. Now let's have a look at similar triangles. In the GCSE, you can often be given two triangles, and you're told they're similar, which means to say the angles are the same, and the sides are in ratio. And you'll be given two corresponding sides. In other words, you'll be given the length of two sides opposite the same size angle. Looking at those two, you can work out what the scale factor is. So that's twice as big. So the scale factor for enlargement in that direction is a scale factor of twice as big. But if you go in this direction, then the scale factor will be an enlargement of a half. In other words, this will be twice as big, whereas this will be half as big. Enlargement of two similar triangles. Let's use the scale factor method, scale factor of 2, or scale factor of half, depending if you go from small to big, or big to small. But sometimes, it's not such an easy way of doing it. Let's look at this question here. Here's the two corresponding sides. How much has that been enlarged by? Well, if you multiply by 4, by 1 1/4, that's 1/4, add on 1/4 of 4, you get 5. So in fact the enlargement between the 4 and the 5 is 1 1/4. So if you want to work out this distance, then you'll need to multiply 3 by 1 1/4. How good are you at doing fractions? And then when you go the other way, you'll have to work out what the scale factor is coming the other way. I suggest that, in fact, when you do these sort of questions, if they're nice and easy and straightforward, and you can see straight away the scale factor is an enlargement of times 2, or times 3, or times 4, then okay, that's fine. But when the scale factor is not quite so nice, it's got a fraction in it, possibly doing it as a ratio question is easier, like this. I want to find out what the length ST is. So I say ST over its corresponding side equals, I went from this triangle to this triangle, so I go from this triangle 5 over this triangle 4. The length of ST to the length of AB equals the length of TU to the length of BC. If you have an enlargement, the sides of the shape are in ratio. If I multiply both sides of this by 3, I get ST equals 5 over 4 multiplied by 3, which is 3 fives of 15 over 4. Which is 3/4 of 12, 3 3/4. I'm suggesting that that is easier than messing about with fractions. Now let's try and find the other missing side, AC. So I write down the side I'm trying to find and put it over its corresponding side. Now I've gone from this triangle to this triangle. So I have to go from this triangle to this triangle when I write down the two sides that I know. The ratio of AC to SU equals the ratio of BC to TU. Now I can multiply both sides by 6.5, and this is what I get. 4 times 6.5, well, 2 times 6.5 is 13, so that's 26 over 5. So that equals 5 and a fifth. Now in the exam, you can do these enlargement questions, these similar triangle questions, either by a scale factor or a ratio. The choice is yours.